All right, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. So today is not going to be quite as cinematic of a video as my most recent one, which was Redfish Madness. And if you have not checked that out, definitely go do so. Lots of cool shots in that one. I'm mixing it up a little bit. I'm actually going to be going for some striped bass today, but I'm going to kind of throw in some clips from a few previous trips that weren't successful enough to make it in their own video, but I'll kind of just compile into this one and we'll just kind of have a little mashup of a few freshwater clips, I guess. I think it should be pretty good. I actually didn't film my intro from this morning because it was pitch black when I was driving here, but I will let you guys know that I did have some good luck on some striped bass, which I was really happy about because I haven't really figured out striped bass. That's the one fish that I have little to no experience in, so to catch a couple is really cool for me, and I think you guys are gonna enjoy it. We're doing some really cool fishing where you're looking for the birds, which are basically just your natural fish finders. The birds are diving down on the bait and the stripers are pushing that bait to the surface, and it's just kind of like this whole like National Geographic situation. It's really sweet. And I was just trolling rattle traps through any bird activity when I had my luck, so check it out. All right, here we go. Fish on. We're on, guys. First fish in the morning. Did not take long. Oh yeah, look at all this bird activity. Oh yeah. That's gotta be a striper. Oh yeah. Come on, buddy. You're barely hooked. Oh yeah, baby. First stripe of the day right there. Doing a little bit of trolling this morning. It's a beautiful fish to get it started right there. Yes, sir. That's how we do it. Absolutely gorgeous. Couldn't be happier with that fish. Heck yeah. Beautiful guy right there. First stripe of the morning. Hopefully more to come. See you later, buddy. All right, guys, we've got a ton of bird activity right up here. They're just dive bombing on bait right now. Things are looking good. Birds everywhere. Look at this. Something might happen. All right, guys, hooked up again. Yes, sir. A lot of activity trolling this morning. All I'm doing is trolling this rattle trap. I'm using my pedals to help keep tension with this fish because striped bass are pretty spastic when you're fighting them. They like to run towards you a lot, and when they do that, you'll lose tension with them. So it actually helps to keep kind of pedaling while you're fighting them. Let's go. Did not expect the bite to be this good this morning, guys. I saw it blow up right in front of me, and I'm like, oh, something's about to happen, and sure enough, get a bite almost immediately after that. Oh yeah. Ooh, felt something weird there. Felt like a hook came loose on him or something. It's running toward me now. He's running right at me. That's why we keep pedaling. Just a little guy, but he fought really hard for his little size.
What's up, little guy? These are the ones you gotta watch out for because they will put a hook right in your hand without a care in the world. Just a little guy, but still a very cool fish. Don't catch too many of them, so it's always a treat to get them. We got a stick right there, son. My heart just stopped right there, man. I thought I just got absolutely mauled by like a 40-pound striper. All right, everyone, so everything has just stopped. No more birds are flying, no more fish are blowing up. It's just kind of an eerie calm right now, and the fishing has just gone dead. It's really nice, but there's no fish. So I'm gonna call it a day, and I'll see you guys back at the truck.
So that was the striped bass fishing. Definitely some of the coolest fishing that I've done recently. I really wanna figure out that fishery out there because freshwater fishing is definitely not my strong suit. So here's a few more clips of when I actually went out on the Santee River looking for big catfish and bowfin. Didn't catch any, but I almost had a $500 casualty, as you'll see.
Well, there she is. I wonder if she still flies. She works, boys. We're still in business. There we go. Got something on there. Oh, it was a tiny bowfin. Microscopic bowfin, about 2 pounds.
Oh, we're getting bit on this rod.
Oh no.
Shoot. That's 2 bites missed so far, guys. Dang, come on, Joseph. You're better than this. All right, so it looks like someone casted their line in a tree and then decided just to cut the line at their rod tip so that there's like an extra 50 feet of line dangling from this tree. That's definitely not the move. I'm gonna tie it off here and just ride away with it and see what happens. All right, so we got most of the line out. Lure still in the tree, but just makes a lot more sense to simply break off your lure, like at the lure, rather than cutting an extra 50 feet of line just to pollute the water with.
Here we go. No.
Yeah, we got him.
No, we don't.
We keep losing fish. Or I keep losing fish.
All right, y'all, that's a wrap. Really appreciate you, as always, for making it to the end of the video. I know this one was not nearly as impressive as my most recent work, but I'm trying to find that balance of staying consistent, but also having high quality videos, because whenever I do those really high quality projects, I have to sacrifice a little bit of the consistency just because it takes so much more time to get all the footage and do all the editing. So I'm trying to, you know, find that perfect balance, have some like really sweet, epic, cinematic videos, and then a few like this, which are just kind of for that whole consistency aspect. Also, real quick, want to tell you guys about this cool company that I've been kind of talking with a little bit. They were kind enough to send me a shirt and this cool hat. They're called Navillus. They're super cool. They're all about conservation, sustainability. All their clothes are made out of bamboo, which is really unique because apparently, from what I've heard, the production of bamboo is a lot more environmentally friendly than typical clothing materials. So they're also a smaller business, so please go ahead and check out their website. They've got some really sweet stuff up there, and supporting small businesses is always a good thing to do as well. And especially now that the holidays are rolling around, you can grab a gift for a friend or a family member. But that's a wrap on this one, y'all. Again, thank you so much for watching as always, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.